So today in linear algebra, very simple concept, and that's the transpose of a matrix. Transpose of a matrix. So if I have a matrix A and it has columns I and j, the transpose of that, the transpose of this we usually write like that, and that is just where we interchange rows and columns. So if I were to have this A11, oops, let's do A11, A12, A21, A22, that's my matrix A. So I'm going to interchange rows and columns. So A transpose is then going to be A11 stays where it is because that changes around. A12 becomes A21, so it is going to move there. So I'm going to have A12 is now suddenly going to be there. A22 is still the same rows and columns, but this one here is going to go up there. So as these just grow bigger, that's what you're going to have. So let's just look at the transpose of a matrix, say for instance, 3, 2, 1, 4, 2, minus 3. So that is a 2 by 3 matrix, and you can well imagine that the transpose of that has got to be a 3 by 2 matrix. So I'm just going to take this row and make it a column. So this becomes 3, 2, 1, and the second row becomes the second column, 4, 2, minus 3. And lo and behold, this is a 3 by 2 matrix. So you see, that's quite simple, this idea of just taking a matrix, taking its transpose. We're just making columns out of rows or rows out of columns. So what happens if I have the following? I have A plus B, and I take its transpose. So remember, if I want to add two matrices to each other, they better have the same size. So let's make this an M by N matrix, and I add to this B, and this must also be an M by N matrix. And the result of that might be another matrix C, but it will also be M times N. Now what happens if I take the transpose? What happens if I take the transpose of this? If I take C transpose, that is going to be N times N matrix. Those are going to swap around. The rows and columns are going to be swapped around. So this was AB. I added them first, and then I got the transpose. If I have A transpose, though, that's going to be N times N. And if I have B transpose, that's also going to be N by M. And if I add them together, I'm also going to get an M by N. So it doesn't matter what you do, this is going to be exactly the same as A transpose plus B transpose. There's going to be no difference between those. Where it gets tricky, of course, is if you do multiplication. We do multiplication. And an easy way just to remember that is remember that if we had AB inverse, that was equal to B inverse A inverse. Same here, that the transpose of AB multiplied first, that's B transpose times A transpose. And let's just look at the dimensionality of this to see that it makes sense. So imagine A is, I'm going to make it A times B, and then that means B must be B times C, because those have to be the same, and this is going to give me a resultant matrix, which is A times C. And if I get the transpose of that, that's going to be C times A. Now let's get B transpose. B transpose here is going to be C times B. And A's transpose is going to be B times A, B times A. And if I multiply that out, that's going to give me another matrix C, which is going to be C times A, which is exactly what we have there. So if I take its transpose, in other words, so that's the transpose, sorry, and the transpose of those two. So I get exactly the same thing as I got here. So please remember that A times B transpose is B transpose times A transpose. So let's have a look at one more thing, which naturally follows from this, and those are the symmetric matrices. So a symmetric matrix is where the matrix is directly equal to its transpose. It's directly to its transpose. Let's have 1, 2, 2, and 5, would that work as A? What would A transpose be? 1 and 2 and 2 and 5. And I have exactly the same thing. I have exactly the same thing that the matrix and its transpose are the same, and those are referred to as symmetric matrices. If I do those two, I get exactly the same thing. So that is something that 1 and 2, that row becomes a column, and that row becomes a column, and they're exactly the same thing. So that will give me a symmetric matrix. What is the inverse of a symmetric matrix? Is that also, so let's stick with a symmetric matrix. I have A equals, 1, 2, 2, and 5. Let's get its inverse very quickly. And there are a variety of ways of doing that. I showed you how to do that if we have 1, 2, 2, and 5, 1, and 0, 0, 1, and we did elementary row operations. What I was going to end up with is 5 and 1 and minus 2 and minus 2. Just check on that. That's exactly what you were going to get. I can do that easily in my head because with 2 by 2 matrices, we just swap these two around and we multiply that by negative 1 and that one by negative 1. And we get exactly that. And what is A inverse? What is the transpose of A inverse? Well, that row becomes a column, and that row becomes a column, and we see that they exactly the same. So if A is symmetric, its inverse is also symmetric. In other words, its transpose is exactly the same as where we started. So these are all very simple things, and I don't think you will ever struggle with that. It'd be very easy to do. One last thing perhaps is, remember vectors and vector multiplication. So imagine, remember I had a vector u, and it's a column vector 1, u2, u3, so this would be in three-dimensional space. And if I have v, and it's v1, v2, and v3, also in three-dimensional space, and I want to get the inner product, the dot product, and I would say u dot v, those two vectors u dot v. And that would be u1, v1 plus u2, v2 plus u3, v3. And that will give me a scalar. And it gives us a very nice way to do this. This idea of a transpose gives us a very nice, because I can also take V transpose U. V transpose U. So if I transpose V, that becomes V1, V2, V3, and I multiply it by U, which is U1, U2, U3, just as we did with matrix multiplication. Remember, we wrote it like this and like this. So it's this column, this row, which is just u1, v1, plus u2, v2, plus u3, v3. So that gives us exactly, you know, that gives us a way to do dot products of two vectors. As you take the second one, take its transpose, put it in front of the first one, and do normal matrix. See, this is a matrix, see, that is a matrix. The transpose, and that naturally follows from that, this scalar or inner product or dot product of two vectors. So in short, that's the transpose of a matrix. There's really nothing to it. I don't think you will ever struggle with a transpose of a matrix, ever struggle with a symmetric matrix. And a nice way to see the dot product or inner product by just using the transpose.